This tutorial is about putting the light spiral round the cocktail glass, okay? And you can do that with a little torch, but today we're going to do it in Photoshop, okay? So I have this glass, cocktail glass. What I did was I put sugar round the rim, filled it with strawberries, and then I used a torch to light paint it, okay? So I'm going to do a few adjustments to it. So if I go over to the right hand side and I go to shadows, okay, here, I am going to drop them right down. Now that'll make my back blacker. Okay, don't worry about this bit here getting darker because we're going to go now to exposure. And we're going to push the exposure up and you can go, but it's far too much. So I would stick about 90, say for talking sake. You could even go lower. About 85 I'm going to go. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the top here, okay? Got all these little places up here. So you've got HSL and grayscale. We want to left click in here and we're looking for luminance. So if it's saturation, it's highlighted, make sure that you left click on luminance. I want to bring out the red and the strawberries a little bit. I want to illuminate them a little bit, okay? See them lightening up? So you can push how far you want. So it's entirely up to yourself, but don't overkill it. Okay, so say I'll do it about 50. So now what I'm going to do is, if you look here, there's part of the black is grey, okay, and a little flecks down here and a little bit missing on the rim, okay. Now this is your raw file here, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to open the image, okay. I'm going to duplicate the layer. Now you can do this by holding down control and then clicking J on your keyboard, or go to the very top up here, left click on layer, go in duplicate layer and just click OK, and it'll do the same thing for you. So what I want to do is I want to clone this part here and this little part. So first of all, I'll go over to the left hand side and I will left click in the clone, the clone tool, okay, and I'll come back over and I'll increase the size of my brush, which is next to the P key on your keyboard, and it's little brackets, so the right one increases and the left decreases. Now I'm going to make this quite big. When you're looking at the screen, you may see it's quite small, okay? So it might not be, it doesn't always show you the size that I'm using, so you adjust accordingly. So next, what I'm going to do is go to the keyboard, hold down Alt, left click on the black, let go, then go up here to where I'm going to color, left click on your mouse and just brush over this little part, okay? So again, we go back over to the left and it's like a little circle with a stick, so it's a zoom tool. So what we're going to do is we're going to left click in there, come back over, and we're going to fill this here. So again, go back over to your clone, left click, back over, adjust your brush size accordingly, okay? And I'm going to get in here and I'm going to hold down Alt and I'm going to left click, and then I'm just going to come along here and just going to brush where I want to clone, and then I'll take another bit from here, okay? And it gives you the little cracks in the sugar, okay? So back over to the left, onto the zoom tool, left click, up to the top here, and it'll say fit screen, so fit screen. Now I feel as if that's tilting over a wee bit to the right, so I'm going to go over here now to the crop tool. So left click in here, and if you go up here to this corner, okay, just left click and gently just turn, okay, and hopefully it'll be straight. If not, just press Control and Z and it'll go back to the way it was. Now back over here and see if it's screen. Okay, so there's a lot of little flecks down here I want to remove, so I'm going to go to the left. I'm going to get the spot healing tool. Now make sure your brush is small enough for these, okay? You don't want it too big, so just go over them slightly, okay, and you'll see them disappear. Okay, now I want to have this bit of light here. You see it, there's a little bit of light. You might not see it actually on the screen, but there's a light here. I want to leave that, okay? I want to remove the bits of sugar that have fell into the strawberries, okay? And these little flakes here, which could be sugar, or it could be light, whatever, but I want to remove them. Okay, so I'm happy with that. So next step is, in fact, I might move this little bit here a little bit. Okay, just a little bit. So next I'm going to go and I'm going to put the light swirl around here. So first of all, if you go over to the left hand side and you'll see the pen tool, so left click, okay, the pen tool, come back over to your glass. Now we're going to start at the bottom. I'm just going to left click and a little square will appear, okay? So say I start about here and you see the little square. So the next one we do, we come up here, we hold down, once we left click, we hold down, okay? So I'm holding down and I want to drag it, okay? That's not going because I stopped, so Control Alt Z, that's because I stopped. So if anything like that happens, just press Control Alt Z and start again. So I'm going to click down and then I'm going to drag. So you can either go that way to start or you can go this way. Okay, so let's start this way. And now the next one that you put up, okay, when you click on it, you'll automatically get a curve at this side. So say we go up here and now you've got a curve here. And we're going to go back up here, okay, and then you have to bring it out so you can go whatever way you want. Okay, now I'm kind of slanting that so that the actual curve, if you look, goes actually up in line. So the next one that we do will be an automatic one. There we are. And then again, we get the curve and we want to tilt it and bring it out, and you can bring it out as much as you want, okay? So we have that one, and then the last one I'm going to do up here, which will automatically appear. There we are. Okay, so next what we do, you can do that different ways. I mean, it always comes out different. You can start the other end and have that behind and not in front. It's entirely up to yourself. Okay, so this one's going to go behind, and you can, if you do it opposite, you might have this part here. So next what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over and I'm going to get the brush tool, and I'm going to go up to this little arrow, and if you come in here, we want to highlight this, okay, and we want to make it 12. Now you can either do it with a little box or just use these sliders, right? So come down now to the bottom right hand corner down here, and you've got a little sort of a square with a turned up corner. It's just like a little bit of paper with a corner turned up. Left click there, okay, and add a new layer. Now we want to go back over to the left and collect our pen tool again. So left click, come back over, and what we're going to do is we're going to right click on one of these lines, and this box will open with all these. Left click and stroke path, okay? And in here, I don't know what you'll have there, but you're looking for brush, okay? And then click OK. So now what we're going to do is we're going to go back over here. Now you see this has come up kind of ready. Go back over here and left click twice in that box. Go down to here, this is your options, okay? And go to inner glow and tick it, outer glow and tick it. Now we go back to inner glow, okay? And we click in there and say we want to change the color. Say we want to go green for talking sake. So we'll go into green, and in here you've got a little box. So see, if you left click in here and highlight it, then right click and copy. We're copying the same colour, okay? So then just click OK on that box. In here you'll see the gradient. So if you left click in here, go to this box, and there's a little black box with an arrow. So just drag it along to the end. Now if it goes down there and you go, oh my god, it's disappeared, it doesn't matter. Just push it back up again and continue along as far as you can go and click OK. So now we're going to go down to outer glow, left click in there. Now we want to get that green. So where this is highlighted, when you go in, right click and paste, and the green will come up the same as the green on the other one, and click OK. Again, you're getting the gradient. So left click, go to the black square and just drag it along to the end as much as you can. Okay. Now we have all the green. We want to do now is we want to click OK, and then go to your keyboard. At the top left hand side it'll say escape ESC, so I want you to double click in there, right, so all the lines will disappear. Go down to the bottom here, okay, and you want to add a layer mask, and then go over to the left, collect your brush. Now go up and make sure you're on a hard brush, okay, because you want crisp lines, and then increase the size of your brush accordingly. So now we're here, we're at the front, and we want to go over the back, okay, but make sure the black is over the white. Go back over and check if that was white over black. I had want black over white, and we just brush down, okay, so try and follow the line of whatever it is you're using, like a glass or a vase or anything. And the same here, okay. Now that's went over there. If that happens, go back over, white over black, and bring it back in, and then go back and put black over white. So we've went front to behind to front to behind, and now we're going front, okay, so we're behind and we go over the front, and now we want to go behind, so you follow the line down, okay, to here, and then you kind of follow that line down in an angle, and we want to follow that in an angle, okay. So it's went from front to behind, front to behind, front, and it's went back to behind, and then it's come back out the front. I think that's a wee bit neat in there. That's two. See, yeah, that's more like it, the actual vase. Okay, so next what we're going to do is we're going to go to the right hand side. If you're happy enough, okay, let's check, and we're going to right click, and we're going to flatten the image. Now what I'm going to do now is I made I made a PNG, okay. Now I'm going to take it in what it was, it's Starbursts. Okay, so I photographed a starburst, and then I put it in, and I made it smaller and whatever, everything to it, and then I added a little bit of white to it. Okay, now you can move them about wherever you want. You might not want it there. Okay, it's entirely up to you. You might want this one down here to start here. You might want it to be here. Okay, so, or this one to be here. So say we put that one there and click OK. Now you've got more, so what you can do is you can go back in and you can re-bring them in again. Okay, and then you can move them about and say we put more over here. And then we click OK. Now if you don't want to keep any, all you do, you go back over, put that black or white. All you do is you go down to the bottom, you add a layer mask, make sure black's over white. Okay, and you look about and then you say, right, okay, I don't want that one, but you see that won't come off because that's on this layer. So what you do is you click on this layer and you bring a layer mask on up here as well, and then you go and then you brush off. So remember to check what layer you're on, okay. So say that one won't come off because that's on that layer. So what we do is we click back on there and we move a few things. So it's entirely up to yourself what you want to be there and what you don't. So photography back there, and I'm going to move them off of there. Okay, so it's up to you. So now what I'm going to do, I'm quite happy with that. Right, you maybe want to add more around this side, it's up to you. So I'm going to go back and I'm going to right click. I'm going to flatten the image. I am going to go over to, in fact, I'm going to duplicate the layer by Control and J, okay, in case I make a mistake. I'm going to go back to clone. Now I want to go in here and I want to get a little bit of this starburst here because it's got a lot of light on it. So alt, hold down alt, okay, over the little middle of the starburst, left click, and then go round the starburst and click in the middle of them, and you'll see you'll get an extra wee bit of glow. Okay, it's entirely up to yourself if you want to do that. Again, I think this one's got quite a lot more on it. Click that one. So you just go around and see which one has the most, or even, I mean, you can even go in here, you don't even need to go there, just click there, and that'll even give you a better glow, a more realistic glow. Okay, so there we have it. We have the light swirl going round the glass, and you can have any colour you want. This is green and it's got a little orange sort of a line through it. You do whatever you want it to be, okay? So I mean, you can even, if you want, you can add down the bottom little glows here or whatever. So if you don't want to do that, just go to Control and Z and that'll take it away. Okay, so I hope you enjoy doing your little swirls and your little stars, and if you don't know how to do PNGs, we can maybe one day start doing that. Okay, thank you. You go over and you flatten the image, and there we have it.